for anyone who's listening out under the show, how important do you think like the coaching is and having someone in your corner like that, you think?
I think it's really important, especially, you know, if you're going through a time of change in your life, especially if you want to have a lot of change in your life and you're not sure how to do that, having somebody that has a really good outside perspective that can kind of look at what's happening from a 30,000 point foot, you know, view and kind of offer you some suggestions and directions on what they see that you may not be able to see yourself. It definitely helps you kind of hone in your vision and create the path that you want, whether it's with real estate or with something else. I mean, yeah. I won't necessarily call them coaches, but they've been mentors me in one industry or another. And they're people that I always reach out to and call if I have certain situations. And so having that resource, that network of people that you can reach out to kind of bounce ideas off of and get different perspectives is huge. And, you know, when you decide to sign up with the coaching program, you really need to make sure that you're all in and that you really take advantage of that coaching and tell them what you want and demand it from them that they give it back to you. So, and we got that from our coaches. So.
Yeah. I was actually shocked in life and air even that, you know, we go to these 3 days and some people will say, well, I haven't called Ken in 3 months. I'm like, what?
Yeah,
like
we
didn't miss them. You know, we don't miss a month. It's, you know, we may have nothing to talk about, but we're going to get on that call because there's going to be something that comes up. There's going to be some area that we just didn't think about. And to add to Eric, yeah, I can't think of time, you know, early on, we got with Fortune Builders kind of early on. And we don't need to talk about that here, but they at least made us do, remember they made us do a 5-year,
yep,
where you want to be. And I can at least attribute to that process is how we kind of got stumbled on the college rentals and how we built up our passive income.
Just writing down your goals and putting that out there in the world, yeah, and kind of visualizing it, thinking about it. I mean, you know, looking back over the last 20 years, I don't think there's anything that I've ever accomplished that I didn't have the forethought or the ambition to go do. Like whether I consciously decided to do it or not, if it was something I wanted to do, it ended up happening one way or another. So, you know, we did those 5-year plan early on and we looked back after 5 years and it knocked out, I think, pretty much all of it. And we're like, all right, well, we need the next, you know, 1, 3, 5, 10 year plan to start. So it's definitely something I recommend people do.
Well, go ahead, Peter. Well, I think a couple of important things that you guys mentioned about the mentorship or coaching is one, all in, and two, demand it. I never heard really that kind of side of it, like demand it from the mentor, demand it from the coach to, you know, deliver on it. And I think you guys, that's why you guys are so successful, because you guys are looking from that point of view.
I mean, you're paying for it, right? You're paying one way or another with your time, with your money for that education and for that consulting. And so, you know, if you need help, you need to be honest with yourself and be honest with your coach and ask for it and say, you know, hit me with it. Just be brutally honest with me. What is it that I'm not telling you? What, you know, Peter's famous for that. What is it that you don't want to talk about?
We've today? Learned you that from Peter.
So let me ask you, what don't you guys want to talk about on this call?